Dear students, force is the first chapter in physics ICSE class 10 board examination. This video will help you revise the whole chapter in question and answer format. Binaural beats in the background will aid in concentration and learning. So my dear students, listen to the audio and simultaneously keep on reading the material for both audio and visual learning so that it leaves an imprint on your subconscious mind and you'll be able to recall it whenever it is required. Section 1. Here we go with our first question. Define the term force. A force is that physical cause which changes or tends to change either the size or shape or the state of rest or motion. Repeat the same question in your brain again and read it aloud. Our next question. State the effects of force applied on A. A non-rigid body and B. On a rigid body. Answer. The force acting on a rigid body changes the interspacing between its constituents particles and therefore can change its dimension and can also produce motion. Whereas the force acting on a rigid body does not change interspacing between its constituent particles and therefore does not change its dimension. However, it can cause motion in a stationary body or can speed up or stop a moving body. Next, what are contact forces? Give two examples. The forces which act on bodies when they are in physical contact are called contact forces. Example, force of tension exerted by a string, force exerted by a spring, etc. What are non-contact forces? Non-contact forces or forces at a distance are the forces which do not involve physical contact between two objects, but act through the space between them. Example, gravitational force, electrostatic force, or magnetic force. What are the general characters of non-contact forces? There are two general characteristics. First, the gravitational force is always of attractive nature, while the electrostatic force and the magnetic force can be either attractive or repulsive. Next, the magnitude of non-contact forces on two bodies depend on the distance of separation between them. How they are dependent? They are inversely proportional to the square of the distance of separation between them. Next, state Newton's first law of motion. The statement goes like this. A body continues to be in a state of rest or of uniform motion in a straight line unless an external force is applied on it. Define Newton's second law of motion. The rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the impressed force and takes the direction in which the force is applied. So we can say the rate of change of momentum delta P is directly proportional to force. What is the SI unit of force and how is it related to CGS unit of force? So, SI unit of force is Newton and CGS unit of force is dyne. Relationship is 1 Newton is 10 raised to power 5 dynes. What do you understand by the term momentum? The force possessed by a body due to the combined effect of mass and velocity of a body is called momentum. State two factors which determine momentum of a body. The two factors which determine momentum of a body are, first, momentum is directly proportional to mass of the body, and second, momentum is directly proportional to velocity of the body. So two things on which it is dependent, mass and velocity, because momentum itself is m into v. Is momentum a scalar or a vector quantity? It's a vector quantity. State unit of momentum in SI system. The unit of momentum in SI system is Newton second. Remember, Newton second. How is the force related to momentum of a body? Force is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum of a body. Under what condition the Newton's second law takes the form of F equal to ma? F equal to ma is possible only if we assume that a unit mass on moving with unit acceleration produces a unit force. State Newton's third law. When one body exerts a force on a second body, then the second body simultaneously exerts a force equal in magnitude and opposite in direction on the first body. What is impulse? Dear students, this is not directly given in your textbooks. So here it goes. It's very important. Impulse, which is denoted by J, occurs when a force F acts over an interval of time and is given by J is equal to F dt. Since force is the time derivation of moment, it follows that impulse is equal to delta P is equal to m delta V. So what is impulse? Impulse is when a force acts over a short interval of time delta T. So F into delta T can also be impulse. What is the physical quantity derived from change of momentum? Force or impulse is derived from change of momentum. What are the forces acting on a box when it is pulled along a frictional surface? Weight of the body will act downwards. Normal reaction will act upward. Pulling force, frictional force acting opposite to the direction of the pulling force. What are the forces acting on a moving rocket? Drag, weight, thrust, and resistance. Is mass conserved in a moving rocket? No. Mass is not conserved in a moving rocket. The oxygen fuel depletes due to combustion, resulting in the loss of overall mass of the rocket. Two bodies A and B of mass 10 kg and 15 kg are at rest. Which body will require greater force to start moving? The body with mass 15 kg will require greater force to make it move from rest. The body of 15 kg mass will have more inertia than the body of 10 kg as inertia is a function of mass. Inertia is directly related to mass. Define absolute unit of force in CGS system and SI system. So in CGS system, the unit of force is dyne. How will we define one dyne? When a body of mass 1 gram is moving with uniform acceleration of 1 centimeter per second square, the force possessed by it is called 1 dyne. Now SI unit of force, it is 1 newton. When a body of mass 1 kg moving with a uniform acceleration of 1 meter per second square, then the force possessed by it is called 1 newton. Now define gravitational unit of force in CGS and SI system. Now gravitational unit of force in CGS is gram force and in SI system it is kilogram force. So let's see how we will define 1 gram force. In CGS, the gravitational unit of force is gram force. It is defined as the force which produces an acceleration equal to acceleration due to gravity in a mass of 1 gram. So 1 gram force is equal to 1 gram into 980 centimeter per second square. So 1 gram force is 980 dynes. In SI system, the gravitational unit of force is kilogram force. It is defined as the force which produces an acceleration equal to acceleration due to gravity in a mass of 1 kg. So 1 kilogram force is 1 kg into 9.8 meter per second square, which is equal to 9.8 newton. So 1 gram force is 980 dynes and 1 kilogram force is 9.8 newtons. Now state the condition when the change in the momentum of a body depends only on change in velocity. The condition is the mass of the body should remain constant. Complete the following statements. The mass of the body can be treated as constant till the velocity of the body is dash. So, the mass of the body can be treated as constant till the velocity of the body is far less than the velocity of light. Then only the mass can be treated as constant. Next, mass into change in velocity is equal to dash into time. So, mass into change in velocity is force into time. The correct option in the following formula is C. Force is m into a. What is the cause of acceleration in a body? A body is accelerated when an unbalanced force acts on the body and the body is not in equilibrium under different forces. Now, a spaceship is moving at a constant speed in space by burning its fuel and ejecting out the spent gases from the exhaust. Answer the following questions. Is there any change in momentum of the rocket? Yes, there is change in momentum of the rocket. Is there any force acting on the rocket? Yes, of course, there is a force acting on the rocket. What is moment? Dear students, there is a difference between momentum and moment. So, read the question very carefully. What is moment? Torque or moment is the tendency of a force to rotate an object about an axis, fulcrum or pivot. So, whenever a force is able to rotate an object about an axis, a fulcrum or a pivot, we say it is moment or torque. What are the factors affecting turning of a body? There are two factors: the magnitude of force applied and the distance of line of action from the pivot. Define moment of force. The moment of force or torque is equal to product of magnitude of the force and perpendicular distance of the line of action of force from the axis of rotation. What are the units of moment of force and how are they related? SI unit of moment of force is Newton meter. CGS unit is dyne centimeter. Gravitational unit in MKS system is KGF meter. And in CGS system it is gram force centimeter. And the relationship: 1 Newton meter is 10 raised to power 5 dyne centimeter. 1 KGF meter is 9.8 Newton meter. And 1 GF centimeter is 980 dyne centimeter. Give examples of turning effect of force. There are many examples. First is twisting the door knob, then pushing the door open. Remember here, the torque is the one which is responsible to open the door. Third, screwing the cap of a bottle. Fourth, playing on a seesaw. Fifth, using a wrench to loosen a tight bolt. And sixth, using a can opener to open a bottle. What is couple? Two equal and opposite parallel forces, not acting along the same line, form a couple. Remember, they do not act along the same line. So, two equal and opposite parallel forces, not acting along the same line, form a couple. What do you understand by moment of couple? The moment of couple is equal to product of either force, one of the forces, the product of either force and the perpendicular distance between the line of action of both the forces. When is a body said to be in equilibrium? When the number of forces acting on the body produces no change in its state of rest or motion, then the body is said to be in equilibrium. What are the conditions for equilibrium? There are two conditions. First, the resultant of all the forces acting on the body should be equal to zero. Second, the resultant moment of all the forces acting on the body about the point of rotation should be zero. What is the principle of moments? According to the principle of moments, in equilibrium, sum of anticlockwise moments is equal to clockwise moments. Define center of gravity. Center of gravity or CG of a body is the point about which the algebraic sum of moments of weights of all the particles constituting the body is zero. So, the entire weight of the body can be considered to act at this point. howsoever the body is placed. Define uniform circular motion. When a particle moves with a constant speed in circular path, its motion is said to be in uniform circular motion. Define centripetal and centrifugal forces. Centripetal force, a force acting on a body towards the center of circular path, is called centripetal force. Whereas centrifugal force is a force acting on a body away from the center of circular path, is called centrifugal force. Choose the correct statement. D1 is the correct statement. An acceleration of 1 meter per second square on a body of mass 1 kg is 1 Newton force. Section 2, which carries questions of 3 marks and 4 marks. So, first question carries 3, 3 and 4. So, total of 10 marks for each question. State the effects a force can produce and give one example of each effect. Force can set a body in motion. For example, a football is set in motion on kicking. Second, force can speed up a moving body. For example, a handcart moves faster when someone pushes it from behind. Third, force can slow down or stop a moving body. Example, when brakes are applied to a running bicycle, it slows down and then stops. Fourth, force can change the direction of a moving body. For example, a football player can change the direction of a moving football by angling his foot. Fifth, a force can bring about change in dimensions. For example, on compressing, the length of a coiled spring decreases and vice versa. Now, prove mathematically that force is equal to ma, or prove that force is rate of change of momentum. Now, we consider a body of mass m, which is initially moving with a velocity u. Now let a force F acts on the body on time for time t, such that it picks up a final velocity v with an acceleration a. Now change in momentum in time t will be given by m delta v. So m into v minus u, that is final velocity minus initial velocity. Now rate of change of momentum will be mv minus u upon t. But we know v minus u upon t is acceleration. Change in velocity upon time is acceleration. So rate of change of momentum becomes, from the above equation, m into a. Also, by Newton's second law, rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to applied force. So force is directly proportional to mv minus u upon t. So F is directly proportional to m into a. To remove the proportionality sign, we put a constant of proportionality, such that if the k, which is equal to 1, so if there be a body of unit mass and unit acceleration, such that the force processed by it is also unit, then force is equal to ma. Now state Newton's second law of motion both in words and in equation form, and under what condition does this equation becomes F. We know Newton's second law of motion, the rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to applied force, and this change takes place in the direction of the applied force. Mathematically, delta P upon delta T is directly proportional to F, or delta P upon delta T is equal to F if all the quantities are in same system of unit. This equation also takes the form F equal to ma when the mass is constant, that is the velocity is much less than the speed of light. Now state the relationship between force, mass and acceleration. Draw graphs showing the relationship between acceleration and mass and acceleration and force for constant mass. Now for acceleration mass, we know acceleration and mass are inversely proportional to each other. So if we draw mass and acceleration graph, it will be a graph like this. Okay, since both the quantities are inversely proportional. If we draw force upon acceleration, it will be a straight line graph, because force is directly proportional to acceleration. Next, choose appropriate words to fill in the gaps. First, the moment of force is another name for dash effect of force. We all know moment of force is another name for
turning effect of force. Next, moment of force is equal to dash multiplied by perpendicular dash between the line of force and the turning point. So the moment of force is equal to force multiplied by a perpendicular distance between the line of action of force and the turning point. Next, turning effect is measured in dash meters. Turning effect is measured in Newton meters because it is a measure of moment. Next, dash can be either clockwise or anticlockwise. Moments can be either clockwise or anticlockwise. What are the two kinds of equilibrium? Define them. There are two kinds of equilibrium, static and dynamic. So static equilibrium, when a body remains in the state of rest under the influence of applied forces, the body is said to be in static equilibrium. You have to remember that body remains in state of rest. Next, when a body remains in same state of motion under the influence of applied forces, the body is said to be in dynamic equilibrium. Next, draw and show the center of gravity for the following figures. I'll show you the diagram. See, for a line, it has to be the geometrical center. For a pipe or a hollow line, it will be the geometrical center in between where there is no mass. In circular lamella, it will be in center. So accordingly, see all the diagrams. For a triangle, it would be the meeting point of all the medians. For squares, rectangles, rhombuses, etc., it will be the meeting point of diagonals. See for hollow cones and other cones. Please see the diagram for yourself for 1 minute. How will you determine the center of gravity of an irregular lamina? Pierce the card or the irregular object in at least 2 places. Suspend the card from one of these holes. Hang a plumb line from the point of suspension. Using the plumb line as a reference, draw a vertical line on the card. Repeat for another hole. Okay. Now, suspend it from the another hole. And repeat the same. Hang the plumb line and draw the reference line. The center of gravity is where these lines cross on the card. See the diagram. This is the first point. And here, on the same line, you have hung the plumb line. So you draw a vertical line. Okay, then you hang it from this point and draw a perpendicular line where these two lines meet is the center of mass. Now differentiate between mass and weight. Now, a measure of the quantity of matter contained in the body at rest is known as mass, and weight is the force of attraction of the body by the earth. Mass is a scalar quantity, whereas weight is a vector quantity. Mass, its SI unit is kg, and in CGS, its unit is gram. Here, the weight, SI unit is newton, and CGS unit is dyne. Fourth, it is measured by physical or beam balance. Now, next are the numericals. I'll stop my narration. You see to the numericals and understand it by yourself. The separation between two charges is doubled. The distance between the charges is doubled. How is the magnitude of electrostatic force between them affected? Next, the separation between two masses is reduced to half. D has become halved or the R has become halved. How is the magnitude of gravitational force between them affected? Calculate the moment exerted with the claw hammer. If the person exerts a force of 80 Newton and distance D is equal to 25 cm. So perpendicular distance from the pivot is 25 cm. Yeah, this is 25 centimeter and force is in this direction. So moment is force into D. So accordingly you measure it and you have to write the direction of the moment also. If the center is here, pivot is here and you are pulling it in this way, okay, So it will be a clockwise, towards the center you have to see, so it will be a clockwise movement. On a seesaw, Mary weighs 600 Newton balances John weighs 200 Newton. When she sits 1.5 meter away from the pivot, how far from the pivot is John? So weight of Mary is 600 Newton, weight of John is 200 Newton. The distance from pivot of Mary is 1.5 meter. We have to find the distance of pivot from John. So we'll apply principle of moments. Just have a look, students. Now calculate the weight of the beam W0 if it is balanced when weight 1 of 6 Newton is hanged on one side, distance 1 is 21 cm and distance 0 is 36 cm. So here is the pivot. The center of mass will act at the center of the beam. Okay, so weight of the beam will be acting here. Okay, and unknown weight is acting here. So for unknown weight, the perpendicular distance is d1. For mass of the beam, the unknown distance is d0. So according to principle of moments, w1 into d1 is equal to w0 into d0. So accordingly put the values and find the weight of the beam. All the best, students, for exams.